Welcome to November to Remember on Bloodbath and Beyond. Today we review the French film Martyrs.
The film was directed by Pascal Laugier. It follows a girl, Lucy, who just escapes from being tortured. She's placed in an orphanage and befriends a girl named Anna. Lucy suffers from delusions that a creature is chasing and harming her. 15 years later, with the help of Anna, she tracks down the people who are responsible for her torture and carries out her revenge. Historically, a martyr is someone who believes in a cause despite the danger that's associated with believing in something like that. It usually ends with their death and then the people hailing them as a hero. And now let's talk about what we liked.
The makeup and practical effects throughout this entire film was absolutely amazing. Just the look for the cuts, the skin, the wounds, everything was perfect and really realistic.
Yeah,
absolutely. Quite possibly the best I've ever seen.
Before we move on, just so you guys know, this movie is kind of split into two movies, which is actually really neat. We haven't really seen that in any of the movies we've reviewed.
Very, very distinct. First half was revenge, second half was torture, and very clearly where the movie splits in that sense.
It was almost as if they made two shorts and then turned it into one run of a film.
Although it was in a similar vein, everything was connected, so I don't think it was disjointed in any way.
No.
It was done really well, and I think the story was pretty awesome. The way that everything kind of flowed, it was like an emotional roller coaster, and then at the end, there's just like a lot of questions that are very subjective, and it's up to your interpretation of what this movie was about.
And it's not just bad filmmaking that left open ends to it. It was legitimately trying to get us to think about it, trying to involve the audience.
The first example that we see is this creature that's running around chasing Lucy and cutting her up and attacking her all the time. And this is almost spot on for what fighting your inner demons is. This is essentially a girl that she left behind that was getting tortured when she escaped, that she probably could have saved, but she didn't. And so it's just her struggles throughout the first half of the film.
It wasn't really put into context. We weren't sure, is this demon real? Can only Lucy see it? Is she just making it up? It was kind of left open.
The costume on this demon was absolutely phenomenal. Just the look that it had, the fact that it was just moving around like a demon, it had the demon face, and it had like the contortionist style of like movement to it, that it gave that creepy feel.
Yep, it was pretty scary. The cinematography was fantastic. The sound design was pretty solid. There wasn't a whole lot of music, especially in the later part of the movie. There's a lot of torture scenes. There's no speaking, and there's no music for a good 30 minutes or so.
And that was really the only time that I like actually clued in, hey, wait a minute, there's been no sound. I haven't heard music in a while.
Not only were they not speaking, we weren't speaking at all. It was just like, whoa. It's just brutal beatings and just sometimes not even beatings, just a girl being tortured in different various ways and just the monotonous life of someone being tortured. Maybe a few second clips and then fade to black. And that would repeat for 30 minutes.
Then we finally get the enlightenment moment, and that's when the music comes into key. It's like orchestrated piano, like the aha moment, as though something good is about to happen.
I like that this film provided a very thorough motivation for the torture. The film that we did last week, a Serbian film, it seemed like it was just a guy putting Milos through the situation for the sake of it. But here we have a society of people, they're almost doing medical research. They're trying to put a person through as much torture as possible, trying to just break them enough that they have some kind of enlightening. They achieve transcendence and they can see the other side. And that's what they're trying to achieve through these brutal methods.
I guess we have to spoil it.
We have to do it.
It does happen at the end that Anna passes through to the other side, and she ends up telling like the head woman in charge of the medical research what her findings were when she went to the other side. And this is why it's really cool, because we don't know what she said to the woman. And she's talking with Itien, another head guy in charge of the research. She doesn't tell him what she heard from Anna, but she pulls out a gun and she just says, "Keep doubting."
Have you ever tried to imagine the other world? Well, have you?
I'm afraid not.
Keep doubting, Etienne.
What this could be seen as is that she either heard what's on the other side and that there isn't anything there, or she heard that she's gonna be fucked regardless if she kills herself now or keeps living forever.
See, I took that as Etienne being still kind of doubtful, because he kept asking questions. Was it clear and it was precise? And it seemed like he was skeptical.
Yeah.
So she's kind of, you know, keep doubting, and then she did it.
Or you think the keep doubting was just, well, I'm going to go to this wonderful place now, or...
Well, that's what I thought
or
at first, yeah.
We've been doing all of this shit for no reason, and there's absolutely nothing there, and we've just spent a lifetime, because this woman's like 70.
It could have been, yeah.
And it's just like, well, we've been torturing people forever, and there's nothing, so fuck this, I don't want to live in this life.
It could have been, after all that work, and she finally gets some concrete from the other side, or so she says,
right.
And then she ends her life without telling a soul what it was. She takes that information with her.
Yeah.
If you look at, like, the expression on her face as she's, like, taking her eyelashes off and, like, preparing, it's almost as if she's preparing to go on and not go to something better, but came to a realization that this is it. It's that look of defeat.
Yeah, this is an interesting ending, and that's why this story was really, really awesome, and I think it's going to be something that we'll think about for the next few days for sure, because we just watched this, so we haven't had time to really let it all sink in, but it was definitely a weird movie, but not in a bad way.
Now let's talk about what we disliked.
Throughout this entire film, we see tons of fades to black. I get what they're going with because they're showing that transition of time, but the fact that every three shots we get a fade, I found that it was overused, and there's other different editing techniques that you can use to show that transition. In the second movie arc, I get where they were going from, and it did kind of make sense. The first one, the Lucy storyline they were going with, it almost had that feel like, is the movie over? Like, it had that, like, third Lord of the Rings feel like, oh, the movie's done, but, like, we're only 5 minutes in. What's going on here?
This is a little nitpicky. I didn't like some of the motivation behind Anna's character. At points, she was, like, really helping Lucy, trying to find her captors and stuff. Lucy obviously goes over the top and kills them all, but Anna finds that one is still alive, and she tries to save her and locks Lucy in a room. What's the best thing that's going to happen? This woman's going to survive and go to the cops, and then they're all fucked?
Yeah.
Like, Anna, I think, made some weird decisions, especially considering that she's been Lucy's, like, best friend for 15 years, and, like, day in, day out.
And in one confused moment,
she's just like, I need to flip the script on this chick, and I'm just gonna sell her out in a minute. Like, I don't believe that, based on what I saw.
And now for our final thoughts and ratings.
I thought this film was incredible. From the cinematography to the sound design and how in-depth this story was. It was so cool. And I really like that they split the story in half and had two different movies. The character development was amazing. Like, you really felt for these two girls. And I just thought that the ending was awesome. So I'm going to give Martyrs 4.5 mice out of 5.
Martyrs was a well-presented film. It was shot beautifully, and the way the story was delivered was unique because they divided it into two different story arcs and were able to tie it in into one. They had some really cool character development, but I find myself being a little bored with it because they were dragging certain parts out a little too much. I found the second arc with all the different torture scenes was a little too repetitive, but it was still a great film, and I did enjoy it. So that being said, I'm gonna give this movie 3.5 goops of food out of 5.
As John and Jay said, Martyrs was an incredibly well put together film. It was well shot, the sound and the makeup and the effects and everything was... It was fantastic. The movie left me guessing throughout it. I felt invested. It was not just for shock's sake. It made me think about what was going on. I cared about the characters, which I can't say I've done a lot of that in the last previous horror movies that I've seen. If you do watch this movie, which I do recommend, see it with subtitles, not dubbed. It took me out of it a little bit. We watched it dubbed instead of subtitled, and it was not good. But I am not going to rate it based on the poor dubbing. So I'm going to give Martyrs 4 torture helmets out of 5.
As always, thanks for watching, like this video, and comment below with your theory on what you think this movie was about. What did you think that the very last scene was trying to get across? To stay up to date with everything Bloodbath and Beyond, make sure you subscribe.